Greetings to you and yours. Welcome to Itiski Unfiltered. Today we are predicting the semi-finals of MTN 8. Cape Town City, Ipeganeni Pirates. Pirates will be home. Escorting Sakamabinzela. We know they are dangerous there. Then Sundowns will be facing Stellenbosch. So the game is Cape Town City and the Pirates ended 1-1. Sundowns ended 1-0. Sundowns lost and the Stellenbosch have an away goal. So there's a mountain to climb there. So Sundowns has to score one, maybe win it 1-0 or either you win it 2-0 to win on the game. Because the 1-0 for Sundowns means penalties. I mean extra time and penalties. But then 2-0 wins the game. Or 3-1 and stuff like that. You know, most the away rules things. So we're predicting the scores. My name is Mtu. Ngamba ninjayami lau Tebza. Yeah. If you've never been here, please click subscribe because you'll have fun. This is the best football channel in the country, currently the fastest growing. Let me give my predictions, right? Skalangan, Pirates is Saturday. Pirates is good in summer means it is very dangerous. They also have an away goal, so they have an advantage. So I'm thinking 2-1.
Hey, Dot.
I'm thinking Pirates is winning 2-1. I'm seeing Ulona Umasonganye being on the mood, and we all know Umasonganye when he's in the mood, kwenzakalani. He plays very well, he connects, the tempo becomes high, amajita nje adlala kamnandi.
Hey, yeah, bafethu. Siyaqala ne, but angifuni ukuhamba manga. My friend beat me to it in a way. Yabo, nami.
Yeah.
In my mind, my first solid thought was Pirates is gonna win that game 2-1. Let me stick to it and agree nom to Gulogu. I'm seeing Pirates winning 2-1. Mainly because we mentioned home ground advantage and I'm sure they want to do it back-to-back. You understand?
Oh, three times.
They want to for sure do that. And the competition, MTN 8, they've gone and won it two times. So why not the third time? And that's my prediction. I'll just go for 2-1 with the Orlando Pirates. Then when I go to Sundowns, 1-1. I can see 1-1. Although the away goal difference is gonna turn things up and whatnot, but 1-1 is a highly possible score because Stellenbosch understands tactically how Sundowns plays, and they've studied them. They've played the competition over and over and over with Sundowns. You understand? It's been season in, season out, and like number games are tough. Sometimes my wife better than Stellenbosch. Be it in the league or the cups. So yeah, my love. Meet Mina. 1-1. My middle Sundowns 1, Stellenbosch 1, Orlando Pirates 2, Cape Town City 1.
So that's a final of Pirates and Stellenbosch. That's what basically you just said. But If you watch the video Pirates Nepulukwane Sundowns Nepulukwane City where Sundowns win 1-0 own goal to make it to the semis. I did say Guti Sundowns struggles when it comes to competition games. And it's been a struggle since last season, young Ton. Because if we're being honest, MTN 8 final, Sundowns lost on penalties last season. Gunet Bank, the run was not beautiful. There was a game Sundowns played with Tugs. I think that game ended on penalties.
Yeah.
Young Todd. Gu Kef, we also. Young Africa, that was Gota Finals. Ended on penalties, 0-0. Went to semis, couldn't score. Didn't even score one goal. Lost 1-0, 1-0, home and away. Those are competitions. We saw Carling Black Label, they were knocked out by TS Galaxy last season. So you see, on competitions, Sundowns has not been doing well.
Yeah.
And that's what I was saying. And it's still continuing. Because even now, Abakoranga today, and they played well. And they had their chances.
Yeah.
They had the chances, Young Tone. So competition football for Sundowns has not been good since last season and is continuing this season. I don't see Sundowns scoring 2 goals. I'll be lying.
Yeah.
Anything can happen.
Yeah.
But I don't see Sundowns scoring 2 goals. Mm-hmm. It's either it's going to be 1-0 and it goes to extra time and penalties.
Mm-hmm.
Or 1-1 Jomobo Ush. I'm stuck in between. I can't predict properly.
Yeah.
Like I'm gone. Yeah. But I don't see Sundowns scoring 2 goals. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I don't know how those 2 goals are gonna come. Again.
Yeah. It's been a real struggle. The stats was mentioned. And when you look at today's stats, in fact, as we mentioned in the video of your analysis, the passes more than 600. So many passes, you know, that's a team that wins. 12 attempts, you know. That's 8 shots on targets. No, not eight. How many? Yeah, 3 shots on targets and
the shots at goal.
So it gives off the fact that we get there and we're watching the game. They do get there. I understand, but it's a matter of converting. And it's been a matter of we do get it. But that doesn't guarantee you or win you the competition. You understand? Uti next time, we'll make sure that we capitalize on the opportunities that we missed last time. Then it's a 50-50 situation. The probabilities are anything. Stellenbosch could get 2 goals. You know, anything could go by indifferently. So now I'm struggling to see a scoring Sundowns, because even in league games, there were problems with the scorings.
Yeah.
If you remember, I understand some penalties questionable, but color about it. So that's why I'm going with you 1-1 and seeing Stellenbosch by Schutz and Jelem Lomen, because Ukora is not the right or that strength currently for Mamelodi Sundowns. Football wise, game wise, everything is good, but when it comes to scoring, my team's never figured really out. Let me say that. They've figured out how to. That's why I mentioned Stellenbosch and their assignment tactically. That assignment, I was saying, Sundowns is a Tanzania. Fago Munyu coach, but Stellenbosch in the understand in the assignment they play like Mamelodi Sundowns. Hence, now they no longer go and play a game where they just sit. Stellenbosch doesn't play ama low blocks, Madlala and Sundowns. It's not that team. It doesn't give them that respect. And now we are born Guti. Sundowns also gives Stellenbosch that respect to Guti. As much as we're going to be threat the back, everyone is trying to be high, but we can't be like slacking because Labanda Baba Slam. So and net depth Stellenbosch Vumela Guti, they can create some magic lape mapita. So hey, mina nyama vel. Kule my predictions wa mbafetu. Ngisetheni ukuthi nyama lapho futhi.
Yeah. Sundowns plays aggressive football.
Mm-hmm.
If formation yabo is aggressive, it team is ongena nga 3 defenders. It's because ukuthi ngifuna ukushaya. Young Tone. So mawuzoba aggressive, ifana nokuthi uyalwa ne, you are fighting someone and lo muntu uza ngamandla like uphonsa incinde ezi 3 per seconds.
Okay.
Young Tone. Uzowenzani? Uzoyemuva.
Yeah.
Because uzama ukwenzani, uzama ukuvika. So that's what teams are doing against Sundowns. Because Sundowns is playing an aggressive football.
Mm-hmm.
They just sit at the back and watch them. Yo, lo muntu lo kunaphonsa incindi, angithola. But le ncindi le ephonswa ile team A1.
Yeah.
It's a knockout.
Catch them.
And if you check, that's what has been happening, even in CAF, even everywhere. Because it's aggressive football. Ponsi incindi totot, ponsi incindi totot. But la bakubamba khona nge-1. It's a knockout.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what has been happening to the Sundowns. I think they need to be more conservative.
Mm-hmm.
Play a normal like formation.
Mm-hmm.
Play 4-3-3.
Mm-hmm.
Be conservative.
Mm-hmm.
Like play 4-3-3. Ube normal nje. Lose the ball. Because that's what Manqoba has been saying. Lose the ball. Mm-hmm. Don't have too much football.
Mm-hmm.
Lose the ball intentionally. Make them feel like they're also having a chance.
Exactly.
Then you have a bamba and counter-attack.
Yeah,
then you have a bamba and counter-attack. That's what Real Madrid does.
Yeah.
Real Madrid not about our couple finishers.
Mm-hmm.
By walking the double Bellingham. By walking then the tag walker 5 players.
Yeah.
5 players walking, not marking.
Yeah.
That's intentional, bro. So that's what has been happening from Sundowns. If Vumelana Nathi or you disagree with us, please comment there and give us your prediction and tell us what you think. But that's my thinking, guys. Ningang Luis, Ning Chay, hey, you don't know Paul.
Yeah.
It's fine. It's fine. It's just my thoughts.
And it's valid, you know. Another side of it, you could see the giving of the ball, let it not come across wrong. We are suggesting that you should just lose or get easily dispossessed.
And Umangoba did say it, they don't want to be in the position of the ball.
You understand?
Mm.
So, giving the team also that much access and the ball and allowing them to gain the confidence now. Because once we gain the confidence as a team, it means we can push up.
Mm.
You understand? It means our numbers now, it build up here too, obviously. Now we want to get our numbers a bit closer to Elon Tuzer, to the 18 and score goals. And then, because we have smart players, that's what we can do. We can just catch them on one pass, feed it to Ushalulile is the speed. He kills it, you know, Usales. But it is true, Guti, you cannot completely. It happens to the best, Manchester City.
Mm.
They were playing Ipswich Town. That's how they caught them.
Mm.
Position. Then what? Akanji, Abubanban, Bale. Understand? Ipswich, one pass. There's spaces in between. Splits the defense. Pagat Gualaban Laba. Strikers go. Yeah, very striker. Yeah, closer in. So Umanqoba Lapo, I see his point. Uguti, there's no need for a complete dominance of that team having 0% position. No. Let's give them that. Let's look at them like opponents. Let's make them feel like we respect them also. We are scared of them. You understand? Let them have that confidence to say we can go with Sundowns. And we know Uguti, in our transitions and our play is gonna be much more smarter because we have a warm queen. They can take shots out of the box if Sebas Valelega cool lapaya. If not, we have Allende, we have Ribeiro, we have all these Matthews, Bonke Labaman Laba. Individually, they are brilliant. So, individual brilliance that gets offered. You made a big example near Real Madrid. They don't play on a structure of we are one unit and we're going to kill you all the time. Unit A1. No, sometimes it's just individual brilliance. Vini takes the responsibility. Rodrigo takes the so it's there. It's sometimes let's not make it go into Guti collectively we score a goal. You understand that? Sometimes that doesn't work.
Yeah.
That patience and everything I span. Let someone individually kill it.
Mm.
We kill the game. And I'm completely in a way, Mina, agreeing vele naye lapho ukuthi this thing of completely having the ball makes you also forget.
Yes.
Because as much as you're aggressive, uzokohla and then you take your defensive line up high. Now your lines, I understand, send coach from zones. And now you're in the wrong zone. And then when they catch you in the counter, when's a little penalty. Because you react quick, right?
Mm.
So, yeah. In the 100% position in fit. Best score. It's frustrating.
That's why Abu Dragon. Abu Gunju. Dragon man, guys. Umbala. That's why about Dragon, but they make some mistakes. It's because now, by penny, compared to, relaxed with the attacker. Then, my boss attacker, compared to, now we're making a quick reaction. Quick reaction, yeah, we come on for to lumchit. Penalty. That's why Umbala always makes those mistakes because now, ukuba ne position too much, se relaxer, se aggressive. You are too aggressive towards the opponent. I'll use another sports example. It's not the same sports as football, but it's still sports. Floyd Mayweather. Floyd Mayweather is okay with you throwing punches because he knows Guti was okay. Young Ton. He's okay with you throwing punches, even though he knows Guti can also throw punches. But Jack Alawa, Ponza just few crucial punches. Shanghai 3. Three crucial punches are my points. So that's what Sundowns need to learn. You shouldn't be always be aggressive. Jalu defending a three. Very young. It's aggressive football.
Mm-hmm.
Be conservative. Use the 4-4-2. Young Tol. Even Ancelotti said it. I'm going back to 4-4-2.
Mm-hmm.
That's conservative. use like ibangathi nje uzodlala nje nawe uzobanikeza ife game kanti uyazi ukuthi what's your plan. Catch them on the break. Manqoba said it but he hasn't done it. So tell us what you think there. That's our thinking from Mitty Scanfield. We are out.